Hey guys, Google just released Android 15's new build, Beta 4, which pretty much contains the final development code before release, and which will most likely coincide with Pixel 9's release. I've gone through and reviewed all the new Android 15 features and changes, and here's all the good stuff you can expect. Let's go. So let's start off with UI and UX changes. First, we have a redesigned volume control, which now shows animated sliders that match the overall Pixel OS theme. Next, we now have a quick select tile for Bluetooth devices. Next, the widgets menu is getting refreshed with an essential section at the top, which are like recommended widgets. We are also getting refreshed widget previews that better show the actual widgets and better displayed in a 2x1 layout. Next, Predictive Back will show a slight preview of the last screen when slightly making the swipe back gesture. Next, you can now change the color contrast of the home screen with default medium or high options. And lastly, there's a new screensaver for home automation controls. Okay, next up are device apps. First, we have partial screen sharing. Before, sharing the entire screen was the only option. Now, we are able to select a specific window to screen share, and it won't show the taskbar or notifications. Next, we have an option to turn on high quality video mode when using the camera as a webcam. And lastly, we can now select a default wallet app instead of Google. Next up, we have some new system settings. First up is the new device diagnostics, which allow us to see the health of our storage and battery, and also run tests for the display and touchscreen. Next, we are now able to see how much space the OS is taking up, as well as temporary files. Next, all downloaded apps now have an app archiving option, which allows you to delete most of the app, but keep user data like settings or save game data. Next, we have adaptive vibration, which will adjust the vibration intensity based on the surroundings. And lastly, we have an adaptive timeout, which will shorten the screen timeout and turn off the screen earlier if it doesn't detect anything from the proximity sensors. Next, we have a lot of new security and privacy updates. First is the new private space, which is by far the biggest new feature on Android 15. This is a separate space on your phone that you can keep sensitive apps and files locked away from the main phone space. It's basically a phone within a phone. Next, USB connectivity will now require authentication when changing the phone's USB mode. Next, we have Wi-Fi privacy. For any Wi-Fi you connect to, you now have the option to use a randomized MAC address and also disable sharing of your device name. Lastly, we now have an option of getting notified when we are connected to an unencrypted network or a network records or identifies your device ID. These are the updates that have surfaced in Android 15 so far. But there's still a lot in development, like audio sharing to multiple Bluetooth devices, a desktop mode, and satellite connectivity. These will likely be added later as version updates. So, what do you guys think of these new updates? Is there anything that you're glad to see? Let me know down in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe so I can keep bringing you the shiny new updates. See you in the next one.